For energy, go to buymdrive.com today. Refind your prime with M-Drive. I'm your stockbroker. You have a stock. You come to me and say, Colin, do we buy it? Do we sell it? Do we hold it? Here we go.
It's time to buy, sell, or
hold. I'd buy that for $1.
Colin will decide if he'll buy
it,
sell,
want you to sell,
or hold.
Please hold.
All right, Colin, buy, sell, or hold. Zion Williamson's next game will be for the Knicks.
Knicks have the second worst record in the NBA. Phoenix has the worst. They're only a half game back of that. The three worst teams all have a 14% chance. I do not believe lotteries are rigged. The Knicks haven't won one since 1985. So if they're rigging them for big markets, Cleveland's won a couple, Orlando's won a few, they're doing a lousy job. I would say yes.
Bye, bye, bye!
I think New York wins the lottery. It's time. I do think they'll end up with the worst overall record. So my hunch is the Knicks get him.
From your lips to the sports god's ears. All right, buy, sell, or hold. LeBron will not add a 2019 All-Star to the Lakers roster this offseason.
By the way, they have space for two max contracts. There are notable free agents, Kyrie, Klay Thompson, Kawhi, Kevin Durant. The most notable, though, is Anthony Davis, who is represented by Clutch Sports. As I said before, here are the three things in a row that LeBron's camp and handlers cannot have happen. He gets hurt, he misses the playoffs, and he doesn't land AD. Because that is horrible for the LeBron brand. And if you look at their next 25 games, 17 against playoff teams, the hurt part's already happened, and the missed playoffs, many believe, Vegas included, is likely to happen. So my gut feeling is
sell, sell, sell.
LeBron will add Anthony Davis. It is really a must this year for his business.
Yeah, it's really not an option. All right, buy, sell, hold. LeBron James will never win another championship.
I thought Los Angeles, we were the first to go out and say it's going to happen. Well, actually, Peter Vesey may have been. But we acknowledged early we thought it was going to happen. And I've always said, I think there's one in here. But a couple of things have happened. LeBron had an injury. I did not foresee that. Paul George stayed in Oklahoma City. I certainly did not predict that. LeBron is in his 16th season. And so I would say,
bye, bye, bye!
Today, this morning, if I was setting odds, I think LeBron's going to get to some Western Conference Finals. But remember, even if KD leaves the Warriors, they have room because they're going to bail on Boogie and probably Draymond to get another star. My gut feeling today is he doesn't win another title. Also, let me throw this out. AD may go to the Celtics, and if he goes to the Celtics, they're not beating Boston in a final with a Lakers roster with LeBron.
All right, buy, sell, or hold. Kevin Durant will be a Warrior next season.
Well, he's the final MVP last 2 years. The Warriors are opening a new arena. Here's what I think is going to happen. If Zion doesn't land for the Knicks, and if Kyrie doesn't go to the Knicks, and I don't think Kyrie will, then Kevin Durant will be looking at a third straight NBA championship with the best coach and co-star of any star in the league. And my gut feeling is,
bye, bye, bye,
that Durant, after they win and he's finals MVP, if he doesn't get Zion in his neck, and if Kyrie doesn't go, and I don't think he will, it would be going to New York by yourself. He's going to see how that looks for LeBron going to L.A. by himself, and people, cooler heads will prevail, and he'll stay. Although the sentiment this morning is he's going.
Buy, sell, or hold, this will be Jason Garrett's final season as the Cowboys head coach.
Well, he's 2-3 in the playoffs, and you're getting to a situation with Dak Prescott. If Dak Prescott is given a large contract, and we would both acknowledge he's going to be given a contract, $28 million, maybe not $25. Wouldn't the understanding be in Dallas, as the offensive line ages, if we're going to pay Dak more than we think he's worth as a B-minus quarterback, then we're going to have to get the most out of him from the coaching staff. Jason Garrett never made back-to-back playoff appearances, so I do think it's Jason Garrett's final year. I think once you pay Dak and you look around this league, Jerry's going to say, I got to get more out of my $26 million a year I'm paying to Dak.
Oh, I don't know. I think Kellen Moore is in line for that spot. All right, buy, sell, or hold. Kyler Murray will be the number one overall pick.
Cardinals have the number one pick. They picked Josh Rosen last year as a quarterback. Manziel and Vic are the only quarterbacks listed 6 feet or under who were drafted in the first round. My feeling on this, because the Cardinals have a huge liability on their hands, it's called their offensive line, with the immobile and susceptible to injury Josh Rosen, that...
Hopefully.
I'm going to hold on this. I think Kyler Murray is a first rounder. I've been told by somebody I trust, a high first rounder. Let's let this puppy sort out. Let's let the interview process sort out. There are people in the rooms in Arizona that are not all in right now on Josh Rosen. Not saying it's right. I'm just telling you, that's what I hear. Tom Brady has taken another pay cut. That's a story today. He's taking another pay cut. Lord, oh, Lord. Do you know last time he got market value was 2010? By the way, that's pre-Giselle. Eight straight years of pay cuts to win. By the way, how many straight years has he been in the AFC Championship? Eight.
They've been able to put a good roster around him. They've proven they can do that.
He's not consumed by stacking money.
I don't think every team's capable of doing that.
8 years, eight discounts, eight AFC championships. You don't see the alignment?
I just don't. Yeah, I do see the alignment. It's Bill Belichick and the Patriots.
Hey, if I could take a pay cut and guarantee ratings.
I would not. Because there's a lot of factors in that. I know Dak's going to get labeled as like greedy and only about the money and all that. Cause that's the big conversation that's going to come up, is whether Dak's going to take a pay cut or not. And he very may well take a pay cut. I don't encourage people to take pay cuts. But they have had him on an incredible discount for the past 3, going into 4 years.
Yeah.
And they've not shown that they can get him to a Super Bowl with basically paying him nothing. So I don't know what evidence they have that if he does take a pay cut, they'll be able to do that.
All right. T.J. Hushman's daughter's around the corner. He's got some harsh words for Steeler management. T.J.'s next. The tough weather. We're in the middle of winter. It's late February. And in most of the country, outside of maybe Florida, a little bit of California, Texas, Louisiana, we've got 4 weeks of winter left. Is that fair? Late March? That's fair.
Hopefully.
Hopefully no vortexes arriving in your neighborhood. And after that, we have probably 8 to 10 weeks of spring. Now, depending on where you live, Pacific Northwest, spring can be longer. Again, the South, spring is shorter. But this is where Michelin Premium Wiper Blades come in. Smart Flex technology. Wiper blades work for your windshield. Unparalleled, streak-free, squeak-free, smear-free, long-lasting all-season performance. Hug your windshield. Curve to the glass. You're going to get rain, sleet, light drizzle, snowstorms over the next 8 to 10 weeks or more, depending on where you live. If you want to see better, if you want to see more clearly, if you want to drive more safely, real easy. Michelin Premium Wiper Blades. Got them at Walmart, Pep Boys, Amazon, other fine retailers. I saw a drone last night. First thing I thought of was Amazon, delivering stuff to your house. First time I ever driving around town, saw a drone right over my car. Thought it was a UFO, and my son said, no, Dad, it's a drone. No, it's probably Amazon.